Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Parampara. Page 9, Mantra 6. Yastu sarvani bhutani.
Yastu sarvani bhutani.
Atmannevanu pashyati.
Atmannevanu pashyati.
Sarva bhuteshu chatmanam.
Sarva bhuteshu chatmanam.
Tato na vijugupsate. ISAVASYOPANISHAD first introduce the Nivritti Marga and Pravritti Marga in first two verses. Afterwards, Upanishad entering the elaboration of Nivritti Marga, that is Sannyasa Marga. Sannyasa Marga or Nivritti Marga means Jnana Yoga Marga. Jnana Yoga Marga means Shravana Manana Nididhyasana Marga. Shravana Manana Nididhyasana Marga means Atma Jnanam, Atma Jnana Phalam. All are given from fourth verse mantra onwards up to eighth mantra, the crux of Vedanta. Atma Swarupam is pointed out, then Atma Swarupa Jnanam, then Jnana Phalam. Veda has come to give that Phalam only. The main aim of Veda, four Vedas, the Upanishadic portion, is the ultimate final Veda Antabhaga, has come to give that Jnana Phalam to every human being. That Jnana Phalam comes in the form of Shoka Moha Nivritti, freedom from sorrow and delusion, and visugupsa. Sixth and seventh mantras, three benefits are given. We are seeing the sixth mantra, where the benefit is mentioned as na visugupsate. So, just as the advertisements the people give, by using this oil, by using this ointment, by using this paste, what are all benefits you get? So every product, they publicize their benefits or advantages of using that. Upanishad also, or Veda also, present in such a way, all these Upanishadic teaching, Atma Jnanam also gives the phalam in that manner. So that is the benefit. But this benefit comes only when you understand Atma Swarupam. Understanding Atma Swarupam is one thing, and falsifying anatma is also another important thing we have to understand. How much important to understand Atma Swarupam as Sat Chit Ananda? I am that Sat Chit Ananda. that much important to know the falsification of Nama Rupa. Nama Rupa has to be falsified. Anatma has to be falsified. Without falsifying Anatma, Nama Rupa, you cannot claim that you are non-dual Brahman. You cannot claim you are non-dual Advaita Atma, you cannot claim without Mithyatva Nischayam. Therefore, we all normally focus on existence, consciousness, nature. We understand and Ananda Swarupam, I am, that is not alone is sufficient. The Nama Rupa Prabhancha, whatever I am experiencing, it is as good as dream objects. That much Mithyatva Nischayam has to take place in the mind. Equally, this knowledge, Atma Satyatva Jnanam, Aham Atma, that much I have recognized Anatma is not at all there. Dvaitam is not at all there. It is only on my lips. It is only an appearance. This must be very, very clear for every mumukshu. Then only your nishtha, jnana nishtha is perfect. That alone is called parakashta. Jnana parakashta. Advaita sthapanam mithyatva nischayam. So, first line we saw, yaha, whoever, the wise person, whoever sees that, anupashyati, anupashyati word is in keeping with the shastric teaching, in artham, anupashyati, in keeping with the Vedanta Vakyam. Without Vedanta Vakyam, your knowledge is not correct. However much be the person is so great, qualified in many subjects, without Mahavakya, without Guru, Upadesha of Mahavakya, no one can get knowledge. That is the idea presented, anupashyati, in keeping with Shastric words, in keeping with Guru Vedanta Vakyam. Kim pashyati, anupashyati, sarvani bhutani atmani eva. All beings, sarvani bhutani, all nama rupas, whatever you are using the words, whatever you are seeing, all objects making use of, all of them, atmani eva. Anupashyati. They are all in Atma only. In Atma means they are all products. They are all depending upon the Karanam Atma. Just as the gold is the Karanam. Ornaments are depending upon the gold for their existence. Similarly, Nama Rupas are existing by borrowing the existence from Atma, borrowing consciousness from Atma. That Atma is myself. Therefore, I am the projector of this waking world. I am the sustainer of this waking world. I am alone is the experiencer of the waking world. Just as in dream, I am alone is the projector of dream objects. I alone sustain all dream objects. I alone experience all those dream objects. None of them are separate from me. None of them are separate from me. They never exist apart from me. Similarly, waking world also, I project, I am the projector of the waking world, objects. I am the lender, sustainer means I am the lender of that existence to every object. The moment I see the object is. So I am the sustainer of the objects. And I am the experiencer of the object. This is the fact we have to grasp. Slowly we have to assimilate, dwell upon that. Sarvani bhutani atmani eva. All beings, bhutani atmani eva. They are all depending upon atma. Waves cannot exist. They are all depending upon water only. Without water, waves are not there. So the disciple wave has to go to guru wave. The disciple, student wave, small wave has to go to a wise wave, guru wave. And the guru also is the body-mind complex only. Guru cannot come as a ghost and teach Vedanta. First of all, we run away. So guru has to come just like us human beings, same form, so that I can look at that guru, I can see and I can study from that guru. So the guru, wise guru, comes and tells, you are nothing but Atma Swarupam. Then second line, Sarva Bhuteshu cha Atmanam. Sarva Bhuteshu, in all beings, one who sees Atmanam, the Self, the Consciousness, Existence, Principle. Sarva Bhuteshu, here Bhuta means whatever you see the objects, they're all made out of Pancha Bhutas. Every object is Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Apaha, Prithivi combination. If you remember Tattva Bodha. Whole your body, bones, blood, flesh, skin, everything in the body is made out of inside also the air principle, heat principle, and earth principle, water principle, all are there in this body. So that intangible energy appearing as a tangible matter. The tangible matter, body-mind complex, is sustained by that intangible energy called consciousness from Vedanta standpoint. Therefore, Atmanam Sarva Bhuteshu. Atmanam means what? Existence, consciousness. Sarva Bhuteshu, in all beings. So existence, existence, existence. Every object is existent. Every object is existent. That objects are nothing but only tangible consciousness. The intangible consciousness alone appearing as tangible body-mind complex. Without easiness, how can you appreciate? Without consciousness, how can you appreciate this body-mind? Therefore, consciousness existence, that is Sarva Bhuteshu, in all objects, behind every object, every Nama Rupa, Sarva Bhuteshu, Atmanam, this Sat Chit, Atmanam, Anupashyati. All are in Atma. Atma is in all. Atma is in all. All are in Atma. Adhara Rupena, Karana Rupena. Karanam is inheres in all karyams. Gold inheres in ornaments. Thread inheres in cloth. Clay inheres in pot, Atma inheres means intertwined in all karya nama rupas. So body mind is also a karyam, a product. The product cannot exist without its karanam, that is Atma, the Self. That Self is I am, karanam. So karya karanam sambandha is introduced in this mantra. Up to here we saw in the last class. Now we have to go to the seventh profound mantra. These two are very, very profound mantras. We enter the next page 10, mantra 7. So, na vijugupsate means I have already explained in the last class. Vijugupsa has got two meanings. Jugupsa means hatred. Na vijugupsate, vi is upasarga. He will not hate anyone, the wise person, whoever knows that Atma alone is everything. There is no second thing really. Whom to hate? He cannot or she cannot hate anyone. Not possible. If there is second thing only, you can hate. Dvesha can come. When there is no second real thing, how can you hate? Suppose you are seeing snake upon the rope. Can you hate that snake? I have seen the snake, therefore I have got a lot of aversion towards that snake. Can you hate that snake? Can your hate will be justifiable? No. You cannot justify your hate towards that snake. Why? What is the reason? Tell me. It is not there. Snake is not there to hate, to develop aversion. There is no second thing other than rope. Snake appearance only. Really it is not there. How can I develop aversion, hatred, jugupsa? If at all jugupsa comes, is it not a bhranti? It is only a bhranti, delusion. Because I am developing aversion upon non-existent snake. I am developing aversion towards non-existent snake. Therefore, jugupsa is not possible because there is no snake and rope. Two things are not there. Rope alone is appearing as snake. Snake is not at all there. Jugupsa, dvesha is not possible. Similarly, a jnani is one who sees sarvam atma alone, na vijugupsate. He will not hate, he cannot hate. Because there is no second real thing other than Atma to hate. Then why this hatred in the world? People are hating each other. You need not hate the person. Mother never hate the child. Even though son or daughter does certain wrong things, we disapprove their wrong actions. We cannot accept them, we disagree with them, but mother cannot afford to hate the son or daughter. Mother may disagree with the son or daughter's actions. Mother never hate the son or daughter. Why? They are not separate from her. She sees them as herself. Son or daughter are not separate from her. Father, mother can never hate them. They hate their actions, not the person, because they are part of me only. Like that, a jnani is one who may disagree with the actions of people, wrong actions, unrighteous actions, of that people, anyone who is around not doing properly, it does not mean they hate the person. Because that person who is doing wrong thing, he is none other than Atma Swarupam only. I myself am alone appearing in that form. How can I hate that person? The person, the core of that person content is Atma. Nama Rupa of that person is Mithya. Therefore, actions are also Mithya. I may disagree vyavaharikali, but I don't disagree with myself who is appearing as Atma Swarupam. So, Jnani vision is entirely different. That's why na vijugupsate. There is no second thing to develop hatred, really. Whatever you are seeing, that hatred towards anatma, nama, rupa, wrong actions, all are only vyavaharikam, mithya. We need not take them seriously. It is a drama. Whole thing is a drama, just as your dream. This is also a drama. Nambave mudile. Kashtamo kashtamana. But this is the truth. What to do? Whether you believe it or not, this is fact. 100% truth. Look into the seventh mantra. Yasmin sarvani bhutani. Atmaiva bhut vijanatah. Tatra ko moha kashokah. Ekatvam anupashyatah. Vijanatah ekatvam anupashyatah. That anupashyati continues here also. A wise person, whoever knows that wise person, a jnani, vijanataha, of that jnani, vision, how is it that vision? This is the jnani's vision, jnani drishti, towards the world. Ajnani drishti is quite opposite to the jnani drishti. Perception towards the world, vijanataha, anupashyataha, the one who is seeing the world from that Upanishadic angle, Shastric angle I have to see the world, not from my Ragadvesha angle, from my likes and dislikes I see the people, I judge the people, suppose that is not Upanishadic angle. So the Jnani is one who sees the world from Upanishadic angle, means Shastric words he received, assimilated, and Upanishadic vision towards the world, Jnani's vision towards the world, both are one and the same. That is called Anupashyataha. That is called Vijanataha. So my vision towards people and objects and Upanishadic vision must be aligned. There should not be any gap, even a wee bit of gap. If it is there, you cannot avoid shoka moha. You cannot avoid delusion and sorrow. If there is any non-alignment in Upanishadic teaching and my perception towards the world, nama rupa, if there is any non-alignment, you can never avoid insecurity. Vijugupsa, another word is insecurity. When I see the second thing really, then only I feel insecure. Dvaitadhi bhayam bhavati, dvitiyadvai bhayam bhavati. The more I see the second thing, there is an insecurity, bhayam comes. Then vijugupsa comes. That's why vijugupsa, another name, word, meaning is insecurity. Once I see the second thing as real, Dvaita Buddhi is there, duality is there in my mind, I feel insecure. It is limiting me, a limiting factor. That limiting factor always makes me more insecure. The more insecure I am, then comes delusion and sorrow. So the delusion and the sorrow won't be there. Paryajnani. Tatra, tatra means in that wise person, whoever knows that Atma is himself or herself. Vijanataha anupashyataha. What? Yasmin sarvani bhutani Atma eva abhut. First line. Sarvani bhutani, yasmin. So in which Atma, all namarupas, sarvani bhutani, all namarupas are nothing but Atma eva abhut. They are only Atma alone. Previous words, mantra, karya, karana introduced. Atma is karanam, namarupas are karyam, I said. Gold is karanam, ornaments are karyam. Dvaitam we have introduced as adhyaropa. That is only for teaching purpose. We should not hold to that. Karya karana introduced. In this mantra, Atma eva abhutu means that karyam is not there at all. Ornaments and gold, you cannot count two. Gold is one, ornament is another. Wherever the gold is, there is ornament. Wherever ornament, there is gold. So you cannot count karyam as a second thing. Can you count? If you count gold and ornament, I take that chain, gold. You take that chain, I take the gold. Try. Is it possible? You take the chain, I take the gold. If there are two, you cannot take, because chain is gold. Chain is nothing other than gold. There are no two things. In Anatha Shanti Prakaranam we saw all firebrand, whatever comes from that, sparks are nothing but only an appearance. Similarly, Atma eva abhut. Atma eva purasthat paschat dakshinataha uttarena. Sarvam Atma eva. Atma eva abhut. When everything is Atma, yasmin sarvani bhutani, in which all nama rupa, really speaking, that karanam alone is there in the form of karyam. You can go further. Atma alone is appearing as jivatma and paramatma. In this body-mind complex, Atma is called as jivatma, micro level. At Maya level, that Atma alone appearing as Ishvara, the Paramatma. One and the same Atma as Dasa, one and the same Atma as Swami. Whatever you call as God in religion, that God is nothing but one Atma with Maya Namarupa. Samashti Stula Prapancha, Sukshma Prapancha, Karana Prapancha put together Paramatma. Vesti Sukshma Shariram, Stula Shariram, Sukshma Shariram, Karana Shariram plus Chidabhasa put together Jivatma. This Jivatma and that Paramatma both are nothing but Atma. Atma eva abhut. That's why in Brahmarpanam Brahmahavihi, That mantra is the essence of Vedanta. Everything is Brahman. There is nothing other than Brahman. Wow, how everything is Brahman. Flower is Brahman because easiness. Clip is Brahman because of easiness. House is Brahman because of easiness. Man is Brahman because of easiness. Now tell me which is, you know, what is not Brahman? In everything easiness is there. Appreciate that easiness, intangible easiness, intangible Namarupa. You have to do this Vidhyasana. Whatever you see object, appreciate every Namarupa, the intangible easiness. Because it is intangible, abstract, formless. You cannot appreciate that without tangible Namarupa. Tangible means visible, contactable, perceptible. That perceptible Namarupa is helping us to appreciate the intangible, abstract easiness. That easiness is called Atma. You are appreciating electricity or fan. You have to appreciate fan or electricity. First fan or first, then electricity, or first electricity, then fan. அதாவது கரெக்டாக சொல்லுவோம், தைரியமாக சொல்லலாம். அது எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி. யூ ஆர் அப்ரிஷியேட்டிங் பல்ப் ஆர் லைட்டு, டியூப் லைட்டு, எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி ஆர் டியூப் லைட்டு, எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி. வித்தவுட் ஹிச் பல்ப் இஸ் நாட் எ பல்ப், ஃபேன் இஸ் நாட் எ ஃபேன். தட்ஸ் வே எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி இஸ் ஃபேனஸ்ய ஃபேன். It is fan of the fan, bulb of the bulb. Without which electricity bulb cannot have any value, fan cannot have any value. Can that electricity be tangible, visible, perceptible? Can you contact with that? After all, ordinary electricity itself is intangible. What to talk of existence? That is why my favorite being means what? I gave one bookmarker. Do you remember? B stands for Brahman. Who am I? I am a being. B stands for Brahman. E stands for existence, capital E. I stands for infinite, anantam. N stands for natural, sentient, consciousness. G stands for governing the entire universe, body mind complex. I am Brahman, who is existence, consciousness, existent, infinite, naturally conscious principle, who is governing, means lending existence to entire universe. Such a me, how can I have shoka, moha, sorrow and delusion? Tatra ko mohaha, kashokaha. For such a jnani, where is the possibility of sorrow and delusion? Worry, tension, guilt, hurt, insecurity, can they exist in that jnani? In that jnani's mind they may exist, but jnani sees the mind. It transcends the mind. Tatra ko mohaha, kaha mohaha, kim shabdaha, that comes, pumlingaha, kaha. Where is the question of delusion and akshayaparthe kim? It is not a question. It is akshayaparthe. There is no delusion at all. It is not possible. What do you mean by delusion? Delusion is nothing but relying upon Nama Rupa for my security, happiness is called delusion. Delusion is simple translation. Moha, delusion. Delusion, confusion, or illusion. Seeing that security, ananda, happiness, where it is not. I want to quench my thirst by seeing marriage water. Is it not delusion? I want to quench my thirst by water, marriage water. Is it not delusion? Can I quench my thirst by that non-existent water, marriage water? Is it possible? Seeing the shell as silver, running after the shell, for as thinking it is silver, is it not delusion? When it is not there, I am running after, that is moha, delusion. Asha, the silver, 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 it is not there. Similarly, son, daughter, if my son stand on his own legs, and he is always standing on his own legs only. This parent, mother and father thinks, if my son stands on his own legs, I am free, I am happy, I am secure. Then only father knows I am more insecure. After they start earning, another insecurity comes to the father or mother. Once they get married and they get children, parents become more insecure. Therefore, I seek security from those objects or people, relations, where real security is not there. I seek my comfort, peace, happiness from objects, possessions, where really they are not there. My mind is so eager to get some comfortable zone from anatma, relations, possessions and people, that is called delusion. How do you know? How can you say, Swamini, that is delusion? My son, my house, my property, all are giving happiness. I question, are they giving happiness all the time? Are they giving comfort all the time? They cannot. Because in anatma there is no comfort at all. In anatma nama rupa there is no possibility of comfort. There is no possibility of security. How can you get? I get water from that marriage water. No? Marriage water, I get little water. Get? Try to get it. I get little bit silver from the shell. Try to get it. You can never. Even little bit, at least 1 gram of silver. So how many 1 gram of silver comes? From my son I get 1 gram of happiness. I get security from 1 kg or 2 kgs of security from my possessions, happiness. My dear, that security, happiness also not coming from them, really speaking. That we'll see later. Therefore, wise person can never have any delusion, because he never rely upon anatma. He knows anatma nama rupa is not at all there. It is mithya. For Vijugupsa, I gave rope snake example. For security, ananda sake, for peace, happiness, I am giving silver and water example, marriage water example. I think you are getting the point. Okay? Pravritti, nivritti. Pravritti towards silver, nivritti from snake. Both are not there. Therefore, my likes and dislikes are also meaningless, really speaking. All my likes and dislikes towards people, towards objects, is it meaningful? Tell me. Once that objects are real, names and forms are real, then my likes and dislikes are all meaningful. Then objects, names and forms, they themselves are not real. How my likes and dislikes towards them can be meaningful? But Irike Swamini, and the likes and dislikes are there. That is called Bhranti. Brahma, I like it, I don't like it. This likes and dislikes, raga dvesha, is a bhranti. Name dvesha ragau, name lobha mohau, moha nasti mama. Name dvesha ragau, name lobha mohau, madho naiva me naiva matsarya bhavaha. Then what? Chidananda rupa shivoham. I am Sat principle, I am Chit principle originally. I am, when I say, you have to go beyond body, mind, pancha koshas. Clear? Otherwise you are lower eye, ahankara, body, mind, complex. It is your role. In Gandharva Veda, they say, the dancers, the one who does drama, dance, or any roles they play, playing that role, they know that role is not real. That role is not real. Afterwards, 2 hours, they go to green room and they cultivate the vesham. Cultivate the vesham, they come normally without makeup. Correct? Similarly, here also, we have to learn mother vesham, father vesham, brother vesham, sister vesham, all are vesham only. In Sanskrit Bharati class, we are in green room now. You are neither father, mother of so and so. You are not brother, sister of so and so. You are not wife, husband of so and so. You are only in green room now. You are Veshi or Vesham. Now, if you are sitting with Vesham, my whole teaching is out. At least 1 hour you are in green room. 8:30 to 9:30 you are in green room. What green room? Vesham cultivated. What Vesham? Husband Vesham, wife Vesham, everything. Temporarily. Okay, don't be afraid of that. Okay. Temporarily, you give up that with your chappal. Na dharmo, na chartho, na kamo, na moksha. So I was muktaha, I am muktaha, I am ever will be muktaha as atma. Therefore, adveshta sarvabhutana maitra karuna evacha. Jnani is so comfortable. That's why Jnani alone is the same person in the world. All other people are ignorant, people are insane and tagararu anartham. Once moha is not there, where is the question of shoka? Moha leads to shoka, sorrow. Once delusion is absent, sorrow is also absent. Sorrow will not be there, cannot be there. That's why jnani is one who is free from sorrow. He is not in the row of sorrow. He is not in the row of, people are all ajnani, people are standing in the row of sorrow. I have sorrow. Dukkham. Rumba dukkhama irukku swami. Dukkham. This person is free from sorrow. Kashokaha. Why? Ekatvam anupashyataha. He sees everything as atma, 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 atma. No second thing. To get moha or to get shoka. It's not possible for a jnani to have shoka moha. They cannot exist in a jnani. Because wise person. Because he sees everything. Ekatvam atma eva asit asti bhavishyati sarvada. Who is that atma? Ahameva asit, ahameva asmi, ahameva bhavami atma sarvada. What about this body mind? That is my vesham, temporary vesham. With vesham we have to listen and own up. Who is a veshi? As vesham I have to hear to know about my veshi nature. I am Atma. So intangible I, the Atma, can grasp I am Atma with the tangible Nama Rupa. So the tangible Nama Rupa Sishya listening to know the intangible Atma of his or her nature. The tangible body-mind complex Sishya is sitting in the class to understand the intangible nature of himself or herself. What is intangible? Like electricity, existence, consciousness. I am, pure existence, consciousness. But happily using all gadgets, panchajnanendriyani, panchakarmendriyani, panchapranas, I am using tangible body, filament, bulb, dome, so much of vasham is there for that, electricity, intangible electricity to manifest using wire connection, glass, inside filament, lot of things are required. Similarly, body also. நம்பவே முடியல என்ன பாடி ஆல்சோ இஸ் லைக் எ பல்ப் ஆர் ஃபேன் ஃபிலமெண்ட் மைண்ட் இஸ் தேர் இன் விச் ஃபிலமெண்ட் எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி லைக் ஆத்மா ரிஃப்ளெக்டிங் அஸ் கான்ஷியஸ்னஸ் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் சிதாபாசா விச் என்லிவென்ஸ் த மேட்டர் பாடி மைண்ட் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் ஃபார் வாட் பர்பஸ் டு நோ மை ரியல் நேச்சர் ரியல்லி ஸ்பீக்கிங் Mirror is to know my real face. Similarly, body-mind complex, the entire body-mind complex is like a mirror to know my real Atma-swarupam. Therefore, keep it clean, maintain it healthy way, and to know, appreciate your Atma. In tangible body-mind complex, you recognize you are intangible Atma-swarupam. That is the only purpose of this body. There is no other purpose. Every body is a mirror like. Mind is like mirror. I, the Atma, reflecting in that, by that reflection, oh, my reflection only. I am only reflecting in the body mind. Very nice, we can talk hours together. Let us go to next mantra. Ko shokaha, kashokaha, tatra ko mohaha. Vijanataha ekatvam anupashyataha, not for all people, only Isavasya Upanishad students, not for all people, this is possible, only students like you who regularly listens to Vedanta. Okay, number 8th mantra, 11th page. This is also the last and final mantra we'll read. Sa parvyaga chukramakaya mavranam asnaviragam shuddhamapapavidham கவிர் மனிஷி பரிபூ ஸ்வயம்பூ யதா தச்சதோர்த்தானம் யததா சாஸ்வதிப்யஸ் ஸமாப்யஹ If you have difficulty, there is English transliteration. You can look into that also. The most toughest tongue-twisting mantra. Very beautiful mantra. Upanishad concludes, Atma is Saha. Saha means that Atma. Paryagat. சுக்ரம் அகாயம் அவ்ரணம் அஷ்னாவிரகம் சுத்தம் ஆல் ஆர் பேரடாக்சிக்கல் வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆர் வெரி 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 பேரடாக்சிக்கல் இம்ப்ளைடு மீனிங் யூ ஹாவ் டு சீ இன் தட் ஃபஸ்ட் ஒன் Let us take Ashna Viragam. Snaha means nadi, nerves, tendons in the body. Avranam means first line, last word. Vranam means wound, literal meaning. I am giving first literal meaning. Sna means nadi, nerve or tendon. Vranam means wound. Avranam means woundless, free from wounds. Avranam. Asnavi. Viragam. Asna viragam means free from the physical body. Ityarthaha. Avranam asna viragam. That whole is one word. Avranam asna viragam. Asna viragam. Together you have to read. Avranam asna viragam. That's why avranam asna viragam. It is combined. I am free from physical body. In the language part, no, Upanishad says, I am free from sthula shariram nu sonna pohadu. Avranam asna viragam. I am free from physical body. Which physical body gets wounds? Which physical body has got nadis? What body? Without a wound, any person can die in life. Without wound. Physical level, one time or other, everybody gets wound. Enge, kai, kaalu, ella edathila, where not. Somewhere or other, sometime or other, each physical body has to get wounds. What about our hero, Atma? Panchakosha vilakshanaha, sariratraya vilakshanaha, sakshina. So first, mantra 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, Atma is presented as existence consciousness principle. That is the first description of Atma. Existence consciousness principle. That means witness consciousness principle. Sakshi Chaitanyam Atma. Then second description of Atma is, Atma is not connected with shoka, moha and dvesha. Atma is not connected with dvesha, shoka, moha. That is the second definition of Atma or description of Atma. Just as the screen is not touched by the movie. Similarly, I, the Atma, am not touched by shoka, moha happening in the mind of that matter. Shoka moha belongs to the matter. Shadurmis belongs to that ashana, vipasa, shoka moha. All these belongs to the physical body, subtle body. Then first line he gives akayam. Kayam means subtle body. Akayam, I the Atma, I am free from subtle body. Nava pancha dhatur, nava pancha koshaha. Akayam means free from gross body. Apranam, sorry. Second line, suddham means karana sharira rahitam, pure. Sambandha karana sharira sambandha rahitam, shuddham. How do you know? Apapa vidham, papam cannot touch me, afflict me. Vidham means afflicted, contaminated or afflicted with papa, papa vidham. Body mind complex is matter. I am spirit is of higher order of reality. Waker is not touched by the dream fire. Waker is not get wet by dream water. Correct? Correct or not? Similarly, I, the Atma, the Self, is formless like space, cannot be afflicted by the matter, tangible matter, body-mind complex. Sthula, Sukshma, Karana, Shariraat, Vyatiriktaha, Panchakosha, Avasthatraya, Sakshi, Aham, Atma. And you get the Madhri Rikyana. Tattva Bodha. I am Atma, Brahma, Soyam Atma, Chatushpad. So, second, third line and fourth line, this Atma alone appears as Jivatma and Paramatma and making a drama. One Atma in the form of disciple, Bhakta, devotee, Swami, save me. Atma in the form of devotee. Another Atma means one, another body, Maya Sahitam Brahma Parameshwara, standing as Swami, I will save you. Swami is there to save, Bhakta is there to get that protection from the Savior. So he is the Savior, I am saved from him. Who is the doing this Vasham? I myself, one Atma, playing the devotee role and Ishvara role. Anga by temple ukkarve, inga stand panni, namaskaramu pannuve. Like a bhakta, namma mudiyala, illa? Idha unmai. That nama rupa, maya sahitam, brahma, ishvara, God is kavihi manishi. Third line. Kavi means omniscient. What literal meaning of kavi is poet. Here, kavi means not poet, but omniscient. Omniscient one. Kavir manishi. Omniscient one. I, the Atma, alone play Jivatma role and Paramatma role. Manishi. Mana plus ishi. Manishi. Mana means omnipotent. Atma. I, the Atma, lend consciousness. Like light, no? To the mind. I lend consciousness to the mind. Therefore, I am omnipotent. Paribhu means I am as Paramatma, all pervading, omniscient one. Transcends nama rupa. He is above me, they say. Above me, and first floor lo ukkarva. My boss is above me, and anartham. Paryaga na above, transcends, superior. That means body, mind cannot touch me, Atma. Because they are tangible, I am intangible. Can bulb touch the electricity? Electricity is in and through the bulb. Electricity is in and through the fan. Can fan contact, give shake hand to electricity? Tell me. Can electricity cat contact the fan or bulb? But is it in and through? In spite of that, bulb or fan cannot touch the electricity. If they touch the electricity, what will happen? Get shocked. Fan gets shocked. They cannot touch contact. Why? It is formless. Formless thing can never be contacted, can never be connected, can never be afflicted. Form irundhane afflict ahum. Body has got a form, therefore it gets afflicted. Mind also has got subtle form. Therefore, it is also getting affliction. Worry, sorrow, guilt, hurt, affliction. But intangible consciousness can never get any afflictions. Paryaga, because it transcends, it is superior. Therefore, it cannot be touched. Paribhuhu, Swayambhuhu. Yeah, the whole this third line and fourth line says is Paramatma is one who is Swayambhuhu, who is the creator of Brahmaji, having created 14 Prajapatis, and Yatha Tathya Arthan, he allots the duties all to the Devatas. First he creates Hiranyagarbha, inge irkar paarunga, Vishnu Murti reclining on the Sesha Sayana. First he creates Brahmaji, and Brahmaji has to create all Samabhyaha. That means all Devatas, corresponding Chakshur Devata, Dik Devata, and Rasana Devata, all Devatas sitting here also and sitting outside also. Brahmaji created by Paramatma, Paramatma creates Brahmaji, Brahmaji creates 14 Prajapatis, 14 Prajapatis creates next generations of Namarupas. Who is that? Aidi Jivatma alone create Paramatma, Ishvara, and that Paramatma, I give job to him as creator, as sustainer, and dissolver. Vishnu, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. Who gave that names? I, the consciousness, existence principle. Therefore, Maiyeva Sakalam Jatam. I am the substratum of the universe. I means not the body-mind complex. It is a medium for me to express myself, the Atma. More you have to contemplate. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.